Welcome to part 2. Let's continue by creating arm bones. Go to the top view and create the clap, shoulder, forearm, and right click to create knob bone and name it wrist. Position them at the right place. Whenever you edit the knob parent, it's good to delete and recreate it. Select them all and reset the stretch. And add L prefix to them. Arms are a bit more complicated than the other parts because we want two systems to animate them. One is called FK, which stands for forward kinematics, and the other one is called IK, inverse kinematics. I want to have them both and be able to blend or switch between them. It's important to note that we don't use these bones in the skinning process. Select shoulder, forearm, wrist, and duplicate them. Add -fk as suffix and remove the last three characters from their name. Select shoulder, forearm, wrist, and duplicate them again. This time add -ik as their suffix. Change the wire color of the IK bones to red and FK bones to blue. You can also change the size of them for an easier selection. And as always, recreate the bone knobs. Select them all and mirror them like the last part. Now select the clavicle bones and link them to a spine tree. To have a better twist on arms, duplicate the shoulder bone and unlink it from its parent. And duplicate the forearm and unlink this one as well. Create two boxes and set their segments to 2 and 3. Use these segments as a guide to refine the newly created bones. Instead of using the mirror tool to create the right roll bones, mirror the guide boxes using working pivot and use them to refine the roll bone of the right side. Go to the front view and create a bone for the left hand and name them L underline hand and L underline hand dash knob. Align it with the wrist in position and align its rotation only in X axis because we have different Y and Z orientations. After editing the hand position, press Reset Stretch. Create the finger bones in the front view. We need two bones for the fingers and one for the knob. And name them Index 1, Index 2, Index 2 dash knob. Copy the fingers and name them Pinky 1, Pinky 2, Pinky 2 dash knob. Link the index one and pinky one to the hand and link the hand to the wrist. Double click on the hand and mirror selected bones. Unlink the base bone from its parent and move it to the right side by inverting the X value of its position. And link it to the wrist. Also, do not forget to rename the bones. Go to the local coordinate system and pivot point center in rotation and you can see the same problem as before. Fix this issue in both clavicles and hand bones. We can temporarily unlink the hands. To have a correct behavior in the Z axis and X axis as well, go to the utilities, enable affect pivot only and transform typing, and rotate the Y axis by 180 degrees. link the hands and roll bones. Fix the names and we are good to go to the next video.